Unit conversion problems come up a lot in science. Sometimes you hear this style of problem solving called dimensional analysis. This is an approach to problem solving that involves using conversion factors and making sure your units cancel. The trick is to look at the units you start with, look at the units you want to end up with, and use a conversion factor to get there. Starting unit times conversion factor equals ending unit. The conversion factor looks like this: ending unit over starting unit. So see how starting unit and starting unit cancel to give you the ending unit. Sometimes you may need two or more conversion factors. We're going to save that for the next video. A conversion factor is a fraction that equals 1. Like 12 inches over 1 foot is a conversion factor. 12 inches is the same as 1 foot, so 12 inches divided by 1 foot equals 1. So if you multiply your original value by a conversion factor, you don't change its value, because you are just multiplying by 1. You just change the units. We could use this conversion factor to go from inches to feet, or from feet to inches. Let's say I started with 36 inches, and I wanted to know how many feet that was. I know that 1 foot has 12 inches, so I can write that as a conversion factor. 1 foot over 12 inches. Now I can multiply these together, making sure my units cancel. 36 inches times 1 foot over 12 inches. Inches cancel. 36 divided by 12 equals 3 feet. Notice that I wrote the conversion factor with feet on top and inches on the bottom, because I wanted inches to cancel, and I wanted feet in my final answer. What if I wanted to convert in the opposite direction? What if I know something is 5 feet long, but I want to know how many inches that is? I can use the same conversion factor, just flipped. I don't have to memorize how to set up the problem. I just make sure the units cancel. I start with 5 feet, multiply by the conversion factor, so feet is on the bottom, so it'll cancel. Inches is on the top, so inches will be the final units in my answer. 5 feet times 12 inches over 1 foot, feet cancel. 5 times 12 equals 60 inches. Let's do a more typical example problem. Something you couldn't figure out in your head right off. If a man has a mass of 75.0 kilograms, what is his mass in pounds? Write what you know on the left, 75.0 kilograms, and write what you want on the right, some number of pounds. Leave a little room for the conversion factor. We will multiply by a conversion factor to change the units from kilograms to pounds. Remember, the conversion factor has to be equal to 1. I would look this conversion factor up, because I probably don't know this off the top of my head, like I do the conversion factor 12 inches for every 1 foot. Okay, so I look it up, and I find that there are 2.2 pounds in every 1 kilogram. Let's write that as a fraction equal to 1. 2.2 pounds over 1 kilogram. As it turns out, we wrote that fraction in just the right way to solve this problem. Can you see that it would not be in the right order if I wrote it as 1 kilogram over 2.2 pounds? That fraction equals 1, but the units wouldn't cancel in our problem. So let's take that out and put it back the right way. 75.0 kilograms times 2.2 pounds over 1 kilogram equals some number of pounds. You can see that the units cancel. Kilograms cancels kilograms, and we'll be left with just pounds, which is what we want to be left with in our final answer. Multiply across the top and bottom. 75.0 times 2.2 equals 165.0 pounds. Make sure you write in the units. Don't forget to check for the number of significant figures. We had 3 significant figures in 75.0, so we can write 3 significant figures in our final answer, 165 pounds.